Good morning. I'm glad to have everyone with us this morning on our videotape service. Today is Mother's Day, the day we honor the lady that gave us life, the most important person to us. But let's open our service today with prayer. Dear gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for this day that we celebrate our mother, the one that loves us, the one that gives us life, the most precious person to us in our whole life. And Lord, we want to bless this congregation here today. I ask that you be with me as I give this message, that you calm me and comfort me and let me give the words that you want me to speak. But Lord, I thank you for everyone that's listening today. I thank you for everyone out there. And Lord, let's make this a great day that we honor our mothers. I pray this in your son's name. Amen. Sing praise with all creation. Sing praise with all of humanity. Sing praise together, for all of our songs come from one God, creator of all. Now for our call to worship, I'll be reading both sides. Sing a new song, a song of love for all. Sing of the spirit of love, the spirit who loves us all. Sing of God's abiding love, that we might love one another in all at all of the world. Sing a new song, a song of love for all.
You hold, oh, he'll descend.
Let us pray. Spirit of love, abide in us and in our worship. Whisper your song of love in our hearts, that love may flow through every word we hear, every tongue, every thought we think, every word we speak, and every song we sing. Spirit of power and grace, abide in us, that we may abide in your love and proclaim your song of love for all. Amen. Good morning, kids. It's good to see you all out there. Well, I can't see you, but it's good, and I hope there's several of you out there listening today. Today is Mother's Day. Boy, we sure love our mothers. You know, my mom's passed. I miss her, but she was very special to me. But you know, we have someone in heaven. We have that lives in us like our mothers live in us, that gives us love like our mothers give us love, and that's our Father in heaven. He, when we get older, you'll learn something about the Holy Spirit, and that's what I'm going to talk about today. But your mother will live inside you forever, just like the Holy Spirit lives inside you. You know, have you ever thought about doing something bad? And I know when I was growing up, and I would be thinking about maybe shooting something with my slingshot that I shouldn't shoot with or shoot or something, and I thought, well, if Dad doesn't find out, it'll be okay. But one of the things that would come into my mind is, Mom, oh, geez, this is different. I could hear Mom. Dad was more like, he's going to punish me. Mom was like, nag it in my ear. Don't do that. This is wrong. You're going to get in trouble, and you know I'm going to find out. Your friend's mother is going to, he's going to tell his mother, and his mother's going to tell me. Then I'm going to have to lecture you. Then I'm going to have to tell you, wait until your father gets home. You know, I'm going to be in trouble. So, you know, sometimes I'd say, okay, it's not worth doing. You know, that part, that's called your conscience. And when you get a little older and the Spirit of the Holy Spirit comes into you, you're going to have a conscience that's given to you by God. You know, so your moms want you to be good and God wants you to be good. So can we remember that and just remember that we need to be good and we need to listen to our conscience? So let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for our mothers. We thank you for the teaching they give us, and we thank you for the love that they give us. Lord, we thank you for that conscience that they start in our hearts. And Lord, we thank you for being the one that continues for the rest of our lives and throughout eternity, teaching us right from wrong, guiding us and leading us just like a mother. And when we think of our mother, I think of you, and I think of the love that you have for me, and I think of the love that my mother had for me. But Lord, I pray that we can honor our mothers today, and I pray that we honor you today. And we pray that we do this all of our lives. I pray this in your Son's name. Amen. This brings us to our prayer concerns for everyone out there. We're not going to list them or go over a lot of them, but Lord, if you have a concern that you want to bring to the attention of someone in this church, me or our pastor or whatever, we're glad to listen to it. And if you look at the description in this service, you have the pastor's phone number and contact information for this church. And if you want me personally, my name, my information is not there, but the pastor will give you my information and I'll be glad to talk to you. But there is so much out there in this world that we need to be concerned about. We have health issues for everyone. We have our political leaders, our government leaders that need to be prayed for. And we just need to get more active in praying for our leaders, that they make the right decisions and the correct decisions, and they remember to keep Christ in their decisions. But if you want, contact anyone in this church, and we will pray with you. We will pray ourselves. We will activate our prayer warriors, and we will have many people praying for you and your concerns. So just remember, you need to contact Rick and call the church. So let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for allowing us to come to prayer with you and being attentive of our concerns and listening to what's on our heart. Lord, you know before we pray what's on our heart, but it is very important to come to you and bring it to your attention personally. But Lord, there's so much out there. There's so many concerns. There's so many fears. As I said, just myself, comfort me and get me through the service today. I seem to be a little nervous. In confession and confessing, that calms me to do that. But Lord, we lift up our political leaders. We lift up the leaders of the other countries that we can have peace. We can get along. These are scary times that we're living in. They're divided times that we're living in. And Lord, you want us to be one. You're there for each and every one of us. And you teach and guide us, and you provide for us. There's no need to want for somebody else's things. You will give us plenty. And Lord, I just thank you for being there for us. I thank you for all the people in my life that has been influenced in me. And I especially lift up my mother today. And Lord, I lift up all the mothers. But I pray this in your Son's name, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Come home, come home.
Today is Mother's Day. Today we celebrate the most precious person in our life. A couple of weeks ago, I talked about God being our Father. And when you accept Jesus Christ into your life, you become a member of this wonderful family. You become a son of God. You have brothers and sisters in Christ, and you're a child of God, a son, a daughter of God. But who's our mother in this family? You know, well, I think God does both jobs quite well. I think God has a softer side. God has a loving side. You know, we know that God's stern and strict and firm and punishes us. And we also know that God loves us. He's got this compassionate side. You know, so I believe God does a real good job of both. I'm not really willing to call God our mother in heaven. I know there's some people that think that. And I'm not going to do that. If somebody wants to do that, I guess it's okay with me. But God is my Father, and He is my mother in a way. But let's see. God, like our mother, gives us life. You know, our mother carries us and brought us into this world. God nurtures us. God teaches us. Our mother teaches us. Our mother feeds us. Our mother cares for us. Our mother loves us. Our mother is a healer. She gives that very special kiss when we skin our knee and it hurts and it makes it feel so much better. Our mothers never give up on us. God never gives up on us. God has this softer side, and I think God does that quite well. And our mother is a part of us that will always live in us. And there's a part of God that will always live in us. When we accept this and we bring Jesus Christ into our lives and we put our lives in His hands and we join this family, God lives inside of us. We are given the Holy Spirit. You know, we have to ask for forgiveness. We have to confess our sins and we have to talk. But God freely gives this Holy Spirit. It comes and it's God's soft side. He comes and lives inside. It is God. And that is how God lives on this earth, is through us and in us. And He's always there and always for us. You know, I told the kids about a conscience. And, you know, when you're younger, you hear this, and it's probably your mom's voice you hear. When you get a little older and you have Jesus and you accept Jesus, you start hearing this conscience, and it might be a little bit bigger booming voice, and it might be a little bit more, you know, don't do that, you know, and He lives and He teaches us the right from wrong. He encourages us. That's what I want to talk about today, is the Holy Spirit. And what is that Holy Spirit that I'm talking about? Well, you've heard of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, the Trinity. You know, we have God, we have Jesus, and we have the Holy Spirit. Jesus had the Holy Spirit in Him. He was God. Jesus was God also and had the Holy Spirit. We have that same Holy Spirit come into us, and we have that same authority and power. It's just, what do we want to do with it? So, we have that same thing. Acts, first chapter, verse 4 through 5. Says, on one occasion, while He was eating with them, He gave them this command. Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait for the gift my Father promised, which you have heard me speak about. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. Butchered that a little bit. But it's a gift from God. God freely gives that gift. And when Jesus was baptized by John with water, the Holy Spirit descended upon Him in the form of a dove. And Jesus started His ministry with the Holy Spirit when it entered into Him. And we get that same Holy Spirit. Again, I want to emphasize that. We get that same Spirit. So he started his ministry. And this spirit that comes lives in us should give you the strength and the conviction to be who God wants you to be, just like your mother does. Your mother gives you strength and gives you conviction to be a good person and how she taught you to be. And with this spirit, when it comes into us, we will receive the fruits of the spirit. And the fruits of the spirit are love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. All very good attributes to have. And they will come, and we will receive them, and we will practice them. And that's the thing. When we receive them, we're supposed to share them with everyone else. We are supposed to be kind and give peace and forbearance and kindness. We're supposed to practice those. We all have our talents that we're good at doing. Some of us are speakers, and some of us are healers, and some of us are prophets, and we all have these things that we're supposed to do. Some of us just have this compassion to serve others, and we're supposed to use these fruits of the Spirit with our talents and start our ministry. Start our ministry as an individual, but start our ministry as a group. We're all part of the body of Christ. Everyone has a job to do to serve our Lord and to bring people to our Savior and into God. And Galatians 6, verse 1 and 2 says, "Brothers and sisters, if someone is caught in a sin, you who live by the Spirit should restore that person gently. But watch yourselves, or you also may be tempted. Carry each other's burdens, and in this way you will fulfill the law of Christ." It's got a lot to say right there. So we're going to get this same spirit, but we're, you know, Jesus was tempted when the Spirit came on him, and Satan was after him all the time. In Luke 4, starting in verse 1, it says, "Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, left the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. He ate nothing during those days, and at the end of them, he was very hungry." And that's where it continues on, is where Satan come and asked him to turn the stone to bread and tempted him. But he tempted him all during that time. He goes, and Jesus knows what's coming, and he's trying to pray, and he's worried about what's coming up. And he's got Satan poking him and nagging him all the time. You know, even though we get this same spirit, life is not going to be easy. Satan's going to poke and nag at each other every step of the way. When I was preparing this sermon, I had several challenges from Satan poking and distracting me, and I even had to ask for an extra day before we recorded this so I could get it done. And he makes me nervous that I'm going to get tongue-tied over what God wants me to say, but I'm trying to speak, and I know, and I take comfort in the fact that the Holy Spirit will guide me in my words, and that's the way life is going to be. We're going to be tempted, and we're going to be challenged, but the Holy Spirit is going to guide us and teach us and show us what we're supposed to be saying. So, you know, just take comfort to know that if Satan's going to tempt Jesus, he's going to tempt you. He's going to challenge you. Next week is Pentecost. It is the day, it is the Sunday, we celebrate the descent of the Holy Spirit on the believers of Jesus. You know, Jesus died and suffered on the cross, rose into heaven, and came back, and he spent time with the disciples. And after a period of time, he went back up into heaven and left the disciples to spread the word. And this is the day, Pentecost is the day we celebrate that. It's the seventh Sunday after Easter. And traditionally, I want to remind you, we wear red on Pentecost Sunday to celebrate that day. So next week, wear red. And we'll all celebrate Pentecost. But the point I want to make about this Holy Spirit is this Holy Spirit is for everyone, equally and justifiably to everyone. It doesn't make a difference who you are. If you accept Jesus, you'll receive the Holy Spirit. Acts 10, 44 through 48 says, "While Peter was still speaking these words, the Holy Spirit came on all those who have heard the message. The circumcised believers who had come with Peter were astonished that the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out even on the Gentiles." So that was even on the Gentiles. The circumcised ones were the Jewish people. They believed in circumcision. The Gentiles were not circumcised. But the Holy Spirit came and goes on to say, "For they heard them speaking in tongues and praising God. Then Peter said, 'Surely no one can stand in the way of their being baptized with water. They have received the Holy Spirit just as we have.' So he ordered that they be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Then they asked Peter to stay with them for a while." So they got the message and they wanted to learn more from Peter. And Peter made sure they was baptized with water. And water, so to speak, is accepting God, I believe. And that is the receiving of Jesus Christ. That's accepting Jesus Christ. And then you receive the Holy Spirit when you do that. And God showed Peter and the others followed Jesus that it was for everyone in that. And it was for all who believed. And we received, and again I repeat, we received that same Spirit. I guess I'm repeating that a lot, but I think that's very comforting to know that, well, Jesus got this, but we only get a little bit. And this person, we all get the equal amount. And so we've received this. What are you going to do with it? You know, you just sit there and wallow in it and enjoy it? Well, here's the thing. And just think of this. Jesus told them not to leave Jerusalem until they received this gift. Not to leave Jerusalem until they received the Holy Spirit. Well, American Express said, don't leave home without it. Well, I'm going to tell you, the Holy Spirit, don't leave church without it. And so you got to practice it. And you've got to start, and we have this ministry. Each and every one of us are to be ministers of God's Word, and we're supposed to reach out to others. So you're going to use this Holy Spirit. You're going to use the fruits of the Spirit to spread God's Word. You can do it in church. You can do it on your own. But it's going to be in you, and you're going to be alive. It's very powerful. It's very, very good. It gives you all strength and the conviction to witness for God and to be the person He wants you to be and to work on bringing people to God. You know, if we don't work to grow the church will die. You know, we have to do things. We have to change our ways. We have to be attractive. Things in the 10th century would not work today in the 21st century. So we have to change our ways, and we have to be motivated, and we have to listen to God. And all these things and all these skills that we develop are used for God. And we're all blessed with that same Spirit, and it's for everyone. So let's use our individual collective ministries and get the word out that God is for everyone. And I want to repeat Galatians 1 through 6. I just want to repeat this. Go over it one more time. "Brothers and sisters, if someone is caught in a sin, you who live by the Spirit should restore that person gently. But watch yourself, or you also may be tempted. Carry each other's burdens, and in this way, you will fulfill the law of Christ." And let's see. Let me see if I can put this in an analogy. I have a sugar problem, and I'm overweight. So I've got a couple of things that are wrong. And if I would eat a piece of cherry pie, I would be not losing weight, which being overweight is a sin. Being I have a sugar problem is a double type sin. I shouldn't have the sugar. So you being my friend would come to me and say, Joe, you really think you need that cherry pie? And you would be telling me gently and restoring me from a sin and with concern. But say you had a sugar problem too, And I said, oh, but this pie is so good. And I've got an extra piece. Why don't you come and sit beside me? I know you want this pie. I could be tempting you. Be very careful. You got to tell me, no, Joe, no, Joe. You know I'm right. You got to stay away from that pie. So you would be restoring me from sin and very gently. And I could be tempting you. Now, carrying my burden would be you knowing that I have this and you being a friend and keeping me accountable. And there could be other things and there could be sins. It could be a lifestyle. It could be many different things. But gently, that's the word. You can't take your Bible and you can't walk around swatting people in the back of the head and quoting this and saying this and that and even kind of twisting those words. Remember, God's word is true. God's word doesn't change. Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. We covered that before. So, but you got to gently talk. Because if you go out there beating on that pulpit today like they used to, you're going to scare everybody off. They're going to turn tail and run. I said, I had a dad like that. I had a mother like that that scared them. I don't need dad anymore. No, you got to gently, gently. So when you do this, you're going to fulfill the law of Christ. Well, what is the law of Christ? What are we supposed to be doing? This Holy Spirit's going to help us fulfill the law of Christ. What is that? John 13, 35 says, a new command I give you, love one another as I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples if you love one another. A lot of loving people, isn't it? Jesus loves us. We know Jesus loves us. You know, he gives us eternal life through God, through this Holy Spirit. Jesus loves us. And we are told to love as Jesus. Jesus said, love one another as you love yourself. Well, that's even a higher level of love, I think, is you if you love as Jesus loved. And that's what we forget in this world, is that love. Because it's a lot easier, I think. Oh, let's smack them upside the head. Let's make them be Christians by beating them. Nah. You do it by love. You do it by being gentle. And we can't forget that. And we're all equal in God's eyes. It doesn't make any difference what your status of life is. It doesn't mean anything of what you have. That poor guy out there on the street corner, we all judge and say, well, he's just trying to make a little extra money. He really doesn't need it. He's probably got a better house than I do. Yeah, we're not supposed to judge him. You know, if you can give him a couple of bucks, give it to him. If it's wrong that you give him money, you're not going to suffer for being good. He's going to suffer for being the one that's asking for money in a false pretense. But we're all equal. And there is no one sin greater than another. So, you know, you have your sins, I have my sins, and someone else we can see has a greater sin we think. No, it's just maybe a little more repulsive to us that we don't like that. But sin is sin. One sin's going to put you in one more nail in the coffin than another one. They're all the same. So I want to read Galatians 5, 25 through 26. Since we live by the Spirit, let us keep in step with the Spirit. Let us not become conceited, provoking, and envying of each other. So, we're all equal. Let us live with the conviction to be the person God wants us to be. We just heard we're not supposed to be all these things. So let us be equal. Let us be convicted to serve our God. Let us be loving. And loving in Christ with the Spirit, loving all people, all God's people as we should. So, can we pray? Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for this Holy Spirit. And Lord, I thank you for the day of Pentecost when you sent this down to earth for each and every one of us and started this Christianity and started this church through your Son and the love that he showed us and teaches us, Lord. And Lord, let us fill Christ's command, Christ's law, to love one another and love as he loved. Let them know that we are his people, we are your children. And guide us and give us the strength through this Holy Spirit that lives in us. And Lord, empower us. Let us walk this earth with you inside us so you can live on this earth also, Lord. I know that you created everything here for me, and you're willing to give it to me. If I can live up to your standards, you will bless me. You will give me many, many, many blessings, Lord. And Lord, I just thank you for the things that I have, and I feel so blessed with what you have given me already. And Lord, I ask for nothing because I know that you have provided me everything that I need. But Lord, I do ask that you enable me to share this word with others, that you give me the ability to witness for you and bring others to you so they can enjoy this wonderful life that you've given me, and that they can understand the love that you have for each and every one of us. I pray this with all of my heart and in your Son's name. Amen. Let us go into this world, let us go out into this universe with the love of Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in our heart, and the knowledge that we are equal and that we all love one another equally and justly. And let us go out with the desire to gently restore our friends and other sinners that we see, that they can become and they can know Jesus Christ. I pray this, and I send you out with these commands. Amen.
Thank you. tears and sadness be before.